Okay, in this class we are going to show you how to use code blocks. It's an IDE, integrated development environment. It basically is free and GPL source code, comes with source code, but you can just download it from Google, search on Google and find code blocks and download it, and make sure you include GCC, the compiler, with it for Windows. So how to install it? It's a free IDE for C++ programming. It comes with GCC and G++ compiler libraries and debugger. Okay, so it's very useful on Windows unless you're used to Visual C++. And the Windows GCC compiler is called the MingW GCC compiler. Install and set it up and put it in C:\tools code blocks. Don't use spaces in your folder names, otherwise you're going to be in trouble trying to set paths. And always run as admin, because a lot of debugging requires administrative rights. So just run as an admin user with no pop-ups saying that like you don't have permissions, and that's the Windows settings. Okay, so how do you run it? You run code blocks, then you click on the top menu and say file, new project, console application. We'll be running only console applications because just want to learn how to use it. We're not interested in GUI applications, which are a lot more complex to start out with. Then you pick C or C++ application that you want to start, what kind of language you're going to use, and pick a new folder to create application. So basically you want to put all of them in your C:\your name / say program one or whatever, and make sure there are no gain spaces in the path, and it's a top level so you can find it. A lot of people put on a desktop, but that's not easy to find in the long run. Then you say click next to finish the wizard, so you get something like this: create a project, file, new project, and then you'll get a project in code blocks. And then pick a console application, and then in code blocks, and the type of program you can pick: C or C++, whatever you want to start learning. And directory to save, you need to give it a title to your project and which folder to save it in. So pick a good folder, and you'll get some path where it gets saved, whole thing. So make sure you remember where you save your projects. And then the compiler you're going to use is GCC. And then it's going to get two configurations, debug and release. Debug contains more symbolic information but slower, and release information config is very fast but it's hard to debug. But you save both of them, and depending on your, first you start with debug, and when you're ready you release the software. So in your workspace you see two windows. On the left side is the workspace and projects. So you go to click on the workspace, you see your project. Your project name is P16 in this case, mine. And inside project has a bunch of source files and sources. You click on the plus sign, it will open up the tree control, and then inside it there's main.cpp, which is the one created by code blocks as a default. And then let's see what the file is. So it's basically including IO stream, and then include using namespace standard. That means you don't have to put standard in front of C out everywhere. It's a default. And then you say int main, that means main is going to return error code back to the operating system. And then you don't need any, you're not going to use any arguments, so you leave it blank, the arguments to main. Then you say C out hello world and end line, and then you return 0, that means no error. So that's your program, first program. Then you need to set your compiler. So you say settings compiler, so GCC compiler, and turn on debugging symbols -G if you're running from command line, so that you can actually step through your code and actually see what's happening. And then in settings compiler, you need to turn on GCC compiler, turn on warnings -val. You always want to see if your code has any kind of issues or not before you actually run it. And there are a lot of settings, you need to go through all of them. And in the settings debugger, you need to set the path to GDB, because that's a debugger you're going to use. And also turn on evaluate expression and a cursor, like Visual C++, so that just by pointing at a variable you can see the value at a variable instead of at runtime, instead of having to type in the value in a watch box. Now you build and run the thing. You can just run it, or build and run is F9. So you run the thing, and what happens is the compiler, you'll see compiler output in the log pane below. If there are no errors, you should get a Your program should run. It should look like this. Hello world, and this is the program. The console window is called a DOS box, and the path to the exe is C:\document settings wherever it got run, but you don't want to put it so far away. It doesn't matter in this case, but you probably need to put it in C:\ your name or something so they can find it again. And then when you press enter, it says 0. That means there are no errors and it took 0.09 seconds to run. And then enter, the console window will go up, and that's about code blocks.